The RAAF is one of the first air forces in the world to field a genuine fifth generation capability. And it could field a sixth generation replacement for its fourth generation FA-18F Super Hornets and EA-18G Growlers by 2040. And elements of a broader sixth generation capability much earlier than that. Before exploring the sixth generation, let's be clear on what a fifth generation air combat capability is. It's about stealthy fighters with lots of sensors. It's also about connectivity, about sharing situational awareness from the radars, electronic warfare equipment, and infrared sensors on our F-35s, Super Hornets and Growlers, P-8A Poseidon Maritime Patrol aircraft, and E-7A Wedgetail Airborne Early Warning and Control aircraft. It's also about secure communications links, passing targeting and situational awareness data between them and associated air, maritime, ground and space nodes, some of them headquarters, some of them carrying weapons or sensors, some of them merely acting as communications relays. Terms like fifth and sixth generation refer to the force's overall capability, and not just to one element of it, as the RAAF has proven in repeated operational deployments. However, technology, including manufacturing technology, is moving so quickly, and the capabilities it enables are developing so fast that one simply can't afford not to contemplate the sixth generation. While the world's leading air forces are contemplating their future needs, the US Air Force is also contemplating upgrading the engines of the venerable B-52H Stratofortress to keep the aircraft flying into the 2050s and beyond, which would make the design more than a century old. At the same time, President Trump's government efficiency czar, Elon Musk, wants to see manufacture of the F-35 stopped and the money diverted to the manufacture of uncrewed aerial systems. And on Boxing Day 2024, China unveiled the Chengdu Aerospace Corporation J-36 stealthy 6th generation fighter bomber. J-36 is still a temporary designation and a smaller Shenyang fighter size design, possibly optionally manned and carrier compatible, that could also be a 6th generation aircraft. All of which confirms the view that the point of balance between large and small aircraft and between crewed and uncrewed aircraft is shifting and hasn't settled as yet. The broad characteristics of the sixth generation are crewed fighters or fighter bombers with even more stealth than a fifth generation aircraft, long range to engage the enemy as far away as possible, optional crewing, very advanced active and passive sensors, enhanced man-machine integration to reduce the pilot workload, highly advanced digital capabilities including AI, data fusion, electronic warfare and cyber warfare, a systems architecture that includes uncrewed aerial systems, low probability of intercept communications between aircraft and between them and other nodes in space, in the air, at sea and on the ground, directed energy weapons, a friendly sensor environment including HQs and reporting centers that maintains situational awareness in real time and gets target quality data to appropriate weapons platforms extremely quickly. Long-range air-to-air and strike weapons. There are four principal sixth-generation development programs underway. The UK, Italy and Japan have formed a UK-based joint venture to support the design, development and delivery of the Global Combat Air Program. The French, Germans and Spanish, and eventually the Belgians, are jointly developing the Future Combat Air System. The USAF is exploring next-generation air dominance, and the US Navy is contemplating its own FA-XX next-generation air dominance program. Meanwhile, the Russians are rolling out the Su-57 Felon and developing the sixth-generation Su-75 Checkmate. The Chinese already have two stealthy fifth-generation fighters, the CACJ-20, which has been widely reported, and the more recent Shenyang FC-31. China has also revealed two new sixth-generation aircraft, the triple-engined CACJ-36 and the twin-engined Shenyang design. India is also contemplating rival fifth-generation designs for its Air Force and Navy. It can't afford both. The Republic of Korea is developing the fifth-generation Kai-KF 21 Boromai Fighting Hawk fighter, which is now in flight testing. And Turkey is flight testing their Kaan fifth-generation fighter. So potential threats and friendly aircraft abound. What the four major allied sixth-generation programs have in common is a crewed aircraft at their heart, and the stated intent of using what the Americans call a collaborative combat aircraft. These will be autonomous, semi-stealthy aircraft with fighter-like range and speed. They will add mass to the airborne force, putting relatively long-range sensors and effectors in useful numbers on semi-attritable platforms and keeping human aircrew out of harm's way, at least some of the time. Most operators would prefer to risk losing a middling, expensive, semi-stealthy UAS to losing a very expensive crewed fighter and its pilot. These sixth-generation capabilities are a response to two things. Most visibly, to the emergence of stealthy, long-range crewed Russian and Chinese platforms in significant numbers and stealthy, high-speed, long-range air-to-air and surface-to-air weapons. However, the Allied sixth-generation programs also maintain national aerospace, AI, communications, quantum science, and stealth research and development programs, as well as a manufacturing sector that's able to produce equipment embodying these technologies. Maneuverability and agility remain important in a sixth-generation fighter, though most air combat now takes place at standoff ranges, so stealth, an excellent ceiling, good sensors, long-range, and long-range missiles matter relatively more in a manned fighter than agility. That said, the F-22's agility, aided by thrust vectoring engine nozzles, is significant. Agility seems to be relatively less important in the F-35. Like the F-22 and F-35, once a highly complex and expensive sixth-generation fighter design reaches the lines-freeze milestone, it's impossible to enhance or change its acoustic, infrared, and radio frequency signatures significantly. All the subsequent development work will go into its sensors, effectors, communication systems, cockpit systems, and propulsion, and maybe into its surface coatings. Which is why it's so important to get the manned platform right. Once you've got it, you're stuck with it. It also means that flight-critical software must be kept separate from sensor and weapon software. The latter may need to be changed relatively quickly, and operators don't want a lengthy, painstaking platform integration program with every update in combat capability, nor the expensive vendor lock-in that seems to go with it. The R&D workload will be massive because, at least for the first iteration of each family of crewed aircraft, its sensors, effectors, communications, and propulsion systems must be considered in parallel with the platform itself. Furthermore, there is no point in fielding an exquisite, crewed sixth-generation aircraft without a supporting fleet of collaborative combat aircraft. So the R&D necessary to develop such collaborative aircraft needs to be considered also. This all suggests a much more intimate relationship between industry and end users, an environment that enables a rapid exchange of views and information and rapid iteration of new technologies. What is Australia's interest in a sixth-generation air combat capability? The life of type of Super Hornet and Growler will be 2040, according to a defence spokesperson. Both capabilities will receive lethality and survivability upgrades while maintaining their interoperability with the United States and other key partners. The F-35A continues to be Australia's most capable and survivable aircraft for conducting air-to-air combat missions against advanced threat aircraft and air surface missions against well-shielded targets. Continued investment in the F-35A fleet will provide incremental improvements to the aircraft's capabilities for decades to come. So we may see a sixth-generation fighter enter the Royal Australian Air Force from around 2040. What about collaborative combat aircraft? The RAAF could buy an American or European collaborative combat aircraft, simply to reduce integration, project management, and supply chain challenges and expense. But the RAAF is still looking closely at the Australian-developed, semi-stealthy Boeing Defence Australia MQ-28A Ghost Bat. In February 2024, Defence announced the allocation of an additional $399 million for the ongoing development of the Ghost Bat. That will see the delivery of three Block 2 aircraft with enhanced design and improved capabilities, as well as enable further development of the MQ-28A mission payloads, integrated combat system, and autonomous systems. It also includes a series of events throughout 2025 to demonstrate operational integration of these capabilities with in-service assets, according to Defence. Each of the major sixth-generation programs is highly classified, and only artists' impressions of the crewed fighters and even some of the collaborative combat aircraft exist. The UK-Italy-Japan Global Combat Air Programme, formerly a UK-led programme based on the Anglo-Italian Tempest and Japanese FX sixth-generation projects, is currently scheduled to enter service as a replacement for UK and Italian Typhoon and Japanese F-2 fighters in about 2035. The supersonic technology demonstrator, which no images exist, passed its critical design review in mid-2024. It will use the UK Pyramid Open Architecture Avionics System to hasten and simplify capability upgrades. The collaborative combat aircraft will be provided by the UK Ministry of Defence under the Lightweight Affordable Novel Combat Aircraft Programme. A first attempt to build a collaborative combat aircraft under Project Mosquito was cancelled in mid-2022 when the Ministry of Defence announced more beneficial, cost-effective alternatives were available, but it hasn't expanded on those. The USAF is currently rethinking the crewed fighter portion of its next-generation air dominance program, which is designed to start replacing the F-22 Raptor in around 2030. Cost is a major consideration. The USAF is simultaneously developing the B-21 radar and a replacement for the Minuteman III ICBM. The service is now seeking a crewed fighter at a much lower price, comparable to the F-35. So the USAF may consider disaggregating major subsystems such as the radar or weapons of a crewed fighter and moving them to other platforms such as collaborative combat aircraft. Likely airframe contractors at this stage are Lockheed Martin and Boeing. Northrop Grumman withdrew from the contest in 2024. Meanwhile, the Next Generation Air Dominance's variable cycle, Next Generation Adaptive Propulsion Program continues with the General Electric XA-102 and the Pratt & Whitney XA-103 competing. At the time of writing, the USAF was deferring decisions on the future of its next generation air dominance until after the Trump administration took over in late January. Meanwhile, the USAF Collaborative Combat Aircraft Program continues and currently sees Anduril with a version probably of its Fury unmanned aerial system, competing with General Atomics with its XQ-67A. Future iterations of the program would allow other players to submit collaborative combat aircraft designs also. The US Navy is working independently on its own next-generation air dominance program, which includes a new multi-role FAXX sixth-generation fighter, which is due to replace the service's FA-18 Super Hornets and EA-18G Growlers from sometime in the 2030s. Airframe primes will be chosen from Boeing, Lockheed Martin, and Northrop Grumman. The program is fighting with the Virginia-class submarine program for finite funds. But the crewed fighter could achieve Milestone B and move to engineering and manufacturing development as soon as late 2025. The FA-XX is designed explicitly to work with collaborative combat aircraft, the first of which will likely be the semi-stealthy Boeing MQ-25 Stingray, carrier-based aerial refueling system, which may also be the platform for stealthier intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance, and kinetic collaborative combat aircraft. The France-Germany-Spain Future Combat Air System program aims to replace those countries' Eurofighter Typhoons and Dassault Rafale Cs by around 2040. Phase 1B, which will define the technologies to be incorporated in the program, as well as the ratio of collaborative combat aircraft to crewed aircraft, is underway after some wrangling over work share. Phase 2 should begin in mid-2025, with a decision on the configuration of the crewed fighter slightly ahead of that. The future combat air system team members are keeping their cards close to their chests. However, the team says the so-called remote carriers, or collaborative combat aircraft, must cost a fraction of crewed fighters because they will be the primary risk takers and will face higher attrition rates. It wouldn't be hard to imagine a force of collaborative combat aircraft flying well ahead of manned aircraft, or supporting land or sea-based weapons platforms to conduct intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance missions, providing or confirming targeting details for weapons with ranges of several hundred kilometres, and conducting other electronic warfare-related missions. And it's no coincidence that electronic warfare is one of the six technologies identified as a priority in Pillar 2 of the Trilateral Security Partnership between Australia, the United Kingdom, and the United States, along with advanced cyber, AI and autonomy, quantum, and hypersonic and counter-hypersonic capabilities. These are all an indivisible part of a sixth-generation air combat capability, and they are the technology challenges facing both operators and innovators.
Thanks for watching. And if you appreciate what we are doing, please subscribe and support us by checking out our merchandise shop.